marker.
Scene one, take one.
Mitch Lieber,
Kaden Canella,
Brooke Maffei,
I'm Maddie Richards, Ellen Nguyen,
Drew Buckley,
Mark Sedgwick,
Truman Talbot,
Ahimi Nagano, Sophie Flora,
Robin Weber.
Hi, I'm Eamon Testerman,
Mishika Shah,
I'm Connor Aher,
Emma Hosted,
Leda Hamidi,
Bryce Bennett,
I'm Marvin Hara,
my name is Mitchell Zone,
Ryan Fondula,
Sara Tayani,
I'm Abigail Rowe,
I'm Caitlin Weber.
I'd probably want to have a compass and a knife.
I'll probably bring a phone and some sort of weapon, like a knife.
Probably bring my phone and a charger.
Probably Maddie and a knife.
I'd bring my friends and a compass.
I'd bring food. Wait, is that like, and my phone?
Chocolate, because I like chocolate. Soda, I like soda.
A plane and chocolate milk.
I would bring a Game Boy, a power bank, and maybe an umbrella.
I'd bring a dog because I love dogs, and probably my dad because he's funny.
I would bring a boat and a TV.
I would bring a plane, a pilot, and probably some like Netflix to watch on my way back to.
It's two things.
Oh, it's only two things?
What? I thought you said three.
I would probably have my phone or some rope to help me survive.
I'd go knife and a good movie.
I would have all the Office and a TV to watch it on.
I'd have a flare gun and an actual gun.
Probably have my phone. I don't know why, but I always need my phone with me. I'd probably also have a book, I guess, to keep me company.
A GPS and a map.
Okay, I think I would take Bear Grylls and maybe a plane.
I'd bring a boat and a phone.
Yeah, I'd probably bring a lighter and maybe a good book.
It's wholesome.
I would be Rainbow. Not Owen, okay?
Oh my.
I thought that through. I'd be a unique color. I'd be clear. Because there is no clear in the crayon box. So
I'll probably choose gold, like a shiny gold color. Because it's very unique and I'm a shiny man.
Turquoise, I like that color.
Probably seafoam green, because it is the best color. And it's Miss Simpson's favorite color too.
I would be probably yellow. Because I just like admire people that can pull off yellow, which I can't.
I would say magenta because it's really fancy.
A mixture of green and blue because I just think that's a nice smooth color.
I'd probably be a mix of blue and purple because it's a nice mixing color.
I think it would be a bright orange, because that matches my personality the most, I think.
I do a mix between white and black.
Probably bright yellow, because it's a happy color.
I'd be the question mark crayon, because, like, you know how there's all those crayons, like, the colors, and then there's one, like, I don't know, hold up. The anonymous color. It's like white, but you don't know what actual color it is.
It's white?
I've never heard of that.
No, I swear it's a crayon. It's a crayon.
That's not.
I'll be the color yellow.
Because your sweatshirt?
Because my sweatshirt and go Hawks.
Clever.
I would be the color blue, because I love blue.
I think I'd be like a nice turquoise, you know, nice little bit of soothing, but also a little pep in it.
I would definitely be black because it goes with everything and every mood.
I'd be green because I like that color.
I would be another blue. It's a good color.
Because I'm not sure. If you want to, you can vote for me, if you want.
It's up to you, just if you want to vote for me, just know I'm a real one.
No. I'm also a real one, so you could vote for me, but I don't really, yeah.
I think it'd be really funny if you voted for me.
Oh my god! I think it would be a fun experience to win.
I think it'd be really cool, and it'd be fun.
Because... I don't know.
Because homecoming king is like awesome, and it would be cool to win.
It's Winterfall.
It's Winterfall.
Personally, I say vote for one of them. They're pretty great.
I say vote for these two. One of them.
Well, you guys should vote for that.
People should vote for me because I'm noticeable, I guess. I'm like pretty tall.
I try to be a nice and friendly person, so that's why you should vote for me.
People should vote for me because I surprisingly got elected this year.
People should vote for me because I'm humble.
Very. Oh, I love it.
Deep question.
That is a good question. People should vote for me because I'm very outgoing.
You can vote for me because I love us. I love the Hawks. Go Hawks.
You can vote for me if you want to. If you don't want to, you don't have to. These are some other great guys over here. You can vote for them if you want, but you can also vote for me.
That's a really good answer. I'm gonna second that.
Please don't vote for me. I don't want this.
So with the retirement of Mr. Gunderson, it's kind of an honor to be able to be interviewed to talk about some of our memories of him. We're one of the fortunate people here that there's like seven or eight of us, maybe we're up to 10 of us who are alumni of Laguna Hills who are back here in some capacity. And so one of the things that I remember the most about Mr. Gunderson as a student was his sarcasm in particular. His sense of humor in class was hysterical.
He escorted Mrs. Martin and me to my son's wedding. All my son's friends there were ecstatic to have Mr. Gunderson at the wedding. They all claimed he was the best teacher they have ever had. But what was really remarkable was his dance steps, man. He was on that dance floor. Couldn't get him off the dance floor.
I've known him in many different capacities. He was my teacher, I was his student teacher, and we've been colleagues for quite a long time now. And I would consider us friends as well. He's a great man, I will miss him a lot, and there are many things that come back when thinking of the times we've shared.
Favorite memories, first of all, of
if you sent an email out to the staff, as a teacher you sent an email to everybody, and you made any mistakes on it, grammatical mistakes, Mr. Gunderson would immediately send an email to the whole staff, including you, correcting your grammatical mistakes. So I was very careful on my emails.
He sort of keeps us on our toes at all times, especially when it comes to grammar, spelling, and any email that goes out.
And if we send out an email that is flawed even in the slightest bit, he will nail us, and we love him for it. But it's totally fine, he does it every time. It's great.
And I'm pretty good about sending out emails with poor grammar, considering who my English teacher was.
Ouch.
I'll miss our times together in the Garden of Eden out back in my room, and the chats we've had. He likes to wander the garden.
Also, seeing Mr. Gunderson walking down the halls with his trademark long basketball shorts on with the Hawaiian shirt, though I never saw him in any of my basketball games.
A favorite memory of Mr. Gunderson is definitely the email and conversations that we go back and forth debating on politics. He's a very bright man and has an interesting take on the political spectrum, and I enjoy engaging in debate with him.
No, Mr. Gunderson, because he had each of my four children, and my favorite memory of him is arguing with me about whether my son Michael should stay in the honors program or not. We would go back and forth about that, and most of our discussions would take place at Patsy's, which is also a favorite memory of mine with Mr. Gunderson, playing trivia.
So there's a group of us that play trivia, and Mr. Gunderson, if you don't know, is very, very good at trivia. So my favorite moments would be when I get a question that he doesn't know. Very, very rare.
He's one of the originals. In fact, I'd say he's the last of the original teachers. He came in and was hired here at Laguna Hills in one of the very first years when the school opened. And that core group of teachers really established Laguna Hills as what it is.
I am going to miss him terribly. We've had a love-hate relationship. He has screamed at me down the halls, but he's a good friend and he's always supported me, and I'm going to really miss him. It's not going to be the same without him here, and I'm going to start crying if I continue.
I'm going to move on to what impact Gunderson had on me as a student. First off, I still remember being in his junior English honors class, and I think he's the first teacher that really made me excited about literature, as far as analyzing literature and looking at it, just thinking about literature so much more deeply. He's definitely the first teacher that did that for me. And I still remember The Great Gatsby, I still remember Scarlet Letter, and I love them. See, I'm getting teary thinking about him leaving.
Yeah.
I think when I consider what Mr. Gunderson means to this school, it's hard to sort of encapsulate. He means so much. He embodies what being a Hawk is all about.
He's just a great human being. He's great for Laguna Hills High School, a true Hawk through and through. He's been great for students, and he will be dearly missed.